At first glance, this town might look fairly unremarkable. But over the past four decades, it has been visited by three presidents of China. Even on a normal day like this, people visit Xiaogang from all over China to learn about its legendary history. Because of these 18 law-breaking farmers who signed the contract, Xiaogang Village became the birthplace of China's rural reforms that helped lift millions of people out of extreme poverty. In the shadow of the Cultural Revolution, dividing up communal farmland could be seen by the authorities as defiance against the socialist system, which might lead to the death penalty. But out of starvation and desperation, the farmers in Xiaogang village had no choice. Under the contract, instead of forced collective farming, each plot would be worked by a household. After handing over the mandatory quota of what they grew to the state and the commune, farmers could keep the surplus for themselves. That meant the harder they worked, the more they earned. This was the first sign of a market-driven economy in communist China.
由于这个劳动力积极性比较好，年龄大的指望能走路的都到田里去搭把手，起早带晚，摸黑能做的晚上都在田里做。我们的粮食从七八年的2万多斤，我们这一年收了13万多斤，反而是超过过去5年的总和。
The success story reached the ears of China's former leader, Deng Xiaoping, who had just taken power and had been looking for ways to transform China's economy. Deng officially validated Xiaogang's innovation. The village became the model for the nation and changed China forever. Xiaogang villagers are proud of this history. The contract with 18 fingerprints can be seen in the town square, in the government-built memorial hall, and also in restaurants. However, the village didn't capitalize on its first mover advantage. Other cities and towns eclipsed Xiaogang. It's now seen as failing to live up to its potential as China's number one rural reform village. The population is also shrinking as the younger generation are leaving for the big cities.
虽然说我们第一步搞了农村这个土地改革的嘛，我们应该说发展是在起跑线的前端，但是香港由于地处农村的偏远地带。 所以对工业这一块，那就是有很多的条件不成熟，一个是交通不便，第二个资金薄弱，甚至没有，第三人才缺乏。我们年龄大了，那需要的就是看他们这下一代。
Yan Yushan, his eldest son, seems confident that Xiaogang can turn things around.
Because I'm 但是我现在呢，实际上回到村里面，进入村联委班子，有这种身份，可以更加赢得老百姓的拥护和信任，为谋求更大的发展创业空间，提供了一个更便利的条件。
On the 40th anniversary of China's reform and opening up, Xiaogang has so far welcomed thousands of journalists. The village has put on a show.
这个像一台戏，就看我们怎么来唱，怎么来策划。这个舞台我们把它搭好了，要演什么节目，谁来演，这个我们说了算。
While the importance of Xiaogang continues to fade, there is no denying that this place and those desperate villagers 40 years ago changed the course of Chinese history.